I explain what is electric lines of force. Electric lines of force. This is a positive charge. It is creating electric field around it. Now bring a unit positive charge, that means Q is equal to plus 1, to a point P which is in the field. Let the charge free to move. Let it to move freely. Then what happens? Due to force of repulsion, that unit positive charge goes away, tracing a path. That path traced by unit positive charge is called electric line of force. So electric line of force is the path traced by unit positive charge. It is away from a positive charge and towards if the charge is negative. So it is away from positive charge and it is towards negative charge, right? First I define what is electric line of force. It is a line or curve which traces this path. Unit positive charge free to move traces this path, right? Electric line of force is a line or curve through which a unit positive charge free to move would travel . Okay, this is point number 1. It is its definition. Next, what is point number 2? It is a open curve. It is a open curve from positive charge to negative charge. These electric lines of force diverge from a positive charge. These diverge from a positive charge and converge to a negative charge. That is our third point. Here I write. They diverge from a positive charge and converge to a negative charge. Electric lines of force diverge from a positive charge and converge to a negative charge. Right. Next. Point number 4. This is an electric line of force. At any point, if a tangent is drawn, that tangent gives you the direction of field at that point. Okay, what is this? This is an electric line of force. Okay, a tangent is drawn at any point in the field, at any point to the electric line of force. That tangent represents the direction of E at that point. So, if a tangent is drawn at any point to electric line of force that represents the direction of field at that point. Okay, next point number 5. Two electric lines of force never intersect. Why? If they intersect, at the point of intersection, you can draw two tangents. It means E will have two directions. It is impossible. So, two electric lines of force never intersect. Point number 5 finish. Next, point number 6. The number of electric lines of force passing through an area normal to it. These are electric lines of force. Imagine an area normal to it, then those electric lines of force move through that area. The number of electric lines of force passing through the area normal to it is called electric flux. Denoted by phi. So, next point, the total number of electric lines of force passing through an area normal to it is called electric flux, denoted by phi. Next, what is flux density? Here I define. Electric flux density, that is nothing but E, total number of electric lines of force passing through unit area. Here not area, passing through unit area normal to it is called electric flux density. Electric flux density is nothing but capital E is equal d phi by ds, where d phi is the total number of electric lines of force, ds is the area. E is equal d phi by ds. Then what is d phi? E dot ds. What is phi? Here I write phi is equal integral E dot ds. Okay, that is total electric flux E dot ds. E bar is a vector, ds bar is also vector. So electric flux is the dot product of electric field intensity vector and area vector. You know what is the direction of E? The tangent represents the E direction. What is area direction? Suppose this is an area. Draw a normal to this area. that normal represents the direction of area. So if you want to find the direction to an area, this is an area. How can you find its direction? Draw normal to this area. That normal represents its direction. Okay. Phi is equal to E dot ds. In which case flux is maximum, in which case flux is minimum? Phi is equal E dot ds, or phi is equal E ds cos theta. If theta is equal to 0 degrees, phi is equal E ds. Okay, flux is maximum. If theta is equal to 90 degrees, phi is equal E ds cos 90 is equal to 0, flux is minimum. So if theta is equal to 0 degrees, that is the angle between E and ds is 0, flux is maximum. If theta is equal to 90 degrees, flux is minimum. Now this is the area. This is the direction of E. Area direction is also same. In such a case, flux is maximum. Suppose this is the area. If E is in this direction, you know area is in this direction. In such a case, the angle between E and area is 90 degrees. In such a case, flux is minimum. So what is electric flux density? Total number of electric lines of force passing through unit area normal to it is called electric flux density. Now what is the unit of phi? What is unit of E? You know, Newton per coulomb, just I explained. What is the unit of area? Meter square. So Newton meter square per coulomb is the SI unit of electric flux. Right.